Hey family, I'm in the kitchen. Normally I cook in my Steelers, but hang this up. Simone made this. I think she was in fourth grade. She made this. So what we did was we got some sausage going first. I blended the sausage in with the meat. We got the sauteed onions and peppers going back there. The best sauce that I went with, I tried a few. I made some variations to the sauce, but what I learned is you can add too much Worcestershire sauce and the dill sauce. You know what I'm saying? So I went straight from the pickle joe. I got my dill. So if that happens where, as you taste it as you go along, if you've made it too salty or if the Worcestershire sauce stands out. Oh, that's good. So if that stands out, you can add cheese. I added a little milk to bring it down. So that cut the edge off the saltiness and the brininess. The dill juice is very briny, you know what I'm saying? So we have the, I went with Angus beef. So we have Angus beef in here with sausage. We got the sauteed onions and stuff back there, the sauteed onions and peppers. And then, of course, the blue cheese stuff, the olives. Gotta rock those. Kill my wine. This is my snack as I cook. So, the usual, guys. So I did add some mayo to this. Recipe called for the creamy Italian. This wine is for my olives. The Worcestershire sauce. Got some Dijon brown sugar in there. I did go with a little smoked paprika, only on the meat, with some garlic and onion and probably some lard. Seasoning salt. Boom. You gotta do that. Every black household needs. I mean, you can't cook meat without putting some lorries on there. My niece is Shalene Shereen. Kill me if I don't. So, like I said, one of the secrets to it is as you mix the sauce, you want to whisk it. So, I found that was a great move. I did add a pinch of flour, I added a little bit more flour. It gave it a consistency, but as you can see, it's still rather thin, but as far as its flavor profile, let me taste it again right now. Let me taste it again, see how we're doing on flavor. For our flavor, we're doing good. So what I would do right now is take a small ladle of this and put it on the onions. So the only thing I put on the onions was a little bit of extra virgin olive oil. That's it, just a tiny bit, and let those saute. So I might put a little sauce on the onions and peppers to give it that flavor right there. The meat is doing good. So that's mainly Angus beef, 100% pure Angus. I didn't go with anything lean. I went with 100% Angus. And then ground sausage is in there too. So that's the stuff that I would get from Scotty's. You know, the beef with the sausage in it. I think Mike's or Tony sells it like that. So boom, 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 that's the way to go. We'll do the bread later. I don't even know where my bread is. Typical hoagie rolls. So we'll toast up the hoagie rolls in a minute. I just want to perfect this sauce. We can keep everything else warm while I get this sauce right. One of the other things I did to bring the sauce down is I added a little bit of American cheese to it as needed to the sauce. Like I said, if it's too salty or if it's too briny, because some flavors of things stand out a little bit more than the other. The creamy Italian really stands out. Worcestershire sauce stands out. So you can just add a slice to that. I did add a 3 tablespoons of milk to that. I was just trying to cut it. I was just trying to cut it and just bring the saltiness down. So I did considerably. Like I said, I added a pinch of flour to it. It made it a little thicker. It's not watery. It's not thick. So the consistency is good. But what I found is over low heat and whisking it really, really helped. So you want to just keep that on low heat and whisk it. and you'll get it right to where you need it. You know what I mean? So you can go with any variation you want. I had a couple other saucepans. I tried different ones. I tried just mayo and the pickle juice. I tried that. Or they say dill, same thing. So I tried that. That didn't work really good at all, because the mayo, unless you just add a tiny bit of pickle juice, that's not gonna work. The mustard, I didn't add any mustard at all. The only mustard I added was to the onions, as in the description that I had. So there you have it. You know what I'm saying? I'll show you the results later. They're gonna come out good. Pete Delaney, for you, baby. Blue cheese stuffed olives. Boom.